For today's lecture, we are going to talk about plant tissue. So what is a tissue? A tissue is a cluster of cells or a group of cells that typically have similar structure that work together for a specific function. They can be classified into meristematic and permanent. Meristematic tissues are those that contain undifferentiated cells. So what are undifferentiated cells? Those are cells that has not yet acquired a special structure or function, or they are not yet mature. So we call them the blank slate. The major function of these undifferentiated cells is to divide and create other cells. And the goal is that the cells they create can become specialized to carry out a specific function. And once a cell or a tissue is specialized or they can carry out a specific function, they are already mature. And we call them the permanent cell or permanent tissues. And we will discuss that later in this lecture. So let's go back to meristematic tissues. Since meristematic tissues have these undifferentiated cells, they are actively dividing tissues. And it is important because it allows the plant to grow and repair damaged tissues. There are types of meristematic tissues based on their position, origin, and plane of division. Based on position or location, it can be classified into the apical, lateral, and intercalary meristems. When we say apical meristem, from the apex, meaning they are found in the tip portions. Or they are situated at the tip. They give rise to the primary meristem or the site of primary growth. So examples are the root and shoot tips. They are the growing tips. For the lateral meristems, lateral, meaning they are found in the side portions. An example of that is the cambium, which is responsible for the secondary thickening of the stem and roots. The intercalary, on the other hand, is found in the internodes and bases of young leaves. The function of this intercalary is to promote the increase in height of the plant. Based on origin, we have the promeristem. Promeristem is a group of young meristematic cells, and they originated from the embryo. So we also call this as the embryonic meristem. While primordia, these are group of cells that represent the initial development of an organ. So in this figure, this is your leaf primordia. So this will become the leaf. We also have the primary meristem. This is derived from the promeristem. So the promeristem produces the primary meristem. And this primary meristem appears in the early stages of a plant life. This is the one responsible for the formation of the permanent tissues and the secondary meristems. Examples of these are the lateral and apical meristem. This figure shows the apical meristem of a shoot. Okay? But we also have a root apical meristem. The primary meristem will give rise to the protoderm, procambium, and the ground meristem. So this is the protoderm, the outermost layer. And this is the procambium. Between the protoderm and the procambium is the ground meristem. The protoderm, procambium, and ground meristem is usually defined as the types of meristems based on function, but technically, they are from the primary meristem or they are produced by the primary meristem. So the protoderm is the outermost plant tissue and it forms the epidermal tissue system or the dermal tissues. So their function is to protect the plants from mechanical shock. Procambium is the innermost layer and they will produce the vascular tissues. While ground meristem is located between the protoderm and the procambium. It will form the cortex, endodermis, pericycle, and pit in dicot. While hypodermis and ground tissues in the monocot. The third type is the secondary meristem. So these are found in mature tissues of roots and shoots. It develops later in the plant life and its function is for adding secondary tissue to the plant body and increasing the girth or diameter of the plants. The examples are the cork cambium and the vascular cambium. So what is vascular cambium and where can you find it in the plants? So from the term vascular, you can find this in between the xylem and the phloem. So this is your phloem, this is the xylem, and this is your vascular cambium. So vascular cambium are actively dividing layer and it is responsible for the increase in diameter of stem and roots and for forming woody tissues. It has two components, the ray initials and the fusiform initials. Both of these are small flattened cells within walls. So when we zoom this portion, this is what it looks like. The ray initials, when compared to fusiform initials, are short and small. So these are the ray initials. And these are the fusiform initials. They are long and narrow. The cork cambium, on the other hand, is located outside the vascular tissue. So this is your vascular tissue, right? And this is the vascular cambium. This is the epidermis and it is followed by the cork. And below the cork is the cork cambium. And cork cambium is also called the spelogen or pericambium. So the functions of this cork cambium is to give rise to the bark and for secondary growth. And since it is important for the bark formation, it is important for the protection against physical damage and prevention of water loss. But they also produce the lenticels. What are lenticels? These are raised pores that allows gas exchange in the bark. Now let's proceed to the type of meristems based on the plane of division. We have the mass, rib, and plate. In mass meristems, cell division occurs in all planes. So there is an increase in volume. You can find this in the embryo and in the sperm. In rib meristem or the file meristem, the cells divide at right angles to the longitudinal axis of the plant organ. So the result is that the cells have parallel orientation and there is only one plane for division. It is a characteristic of organs with cylindrical structure or form, such as the pit of the roots and the stems and petiole. The plate meristem, on the other hand, have cells that divide and increase in number in one layer only. So they divide in two planes but in one layer, resulting to an increase in length but not in thickness. So this can be seen in flat organs, which is the leaf. Now let's go to the permanent tissues. So permanent tissues are derived from the meristems, which have attained maturity. So therefore, they have specific functions. And this can be classified into simple and complex. So when we say simple, these are tissues that is composed of only one cell type. So They are either made of parenchyma cells only, or colenchyma cells, or sclerenchyma cells. While complex, they are made of several types of cells. So normally, a cell can differentiate into three types of tissues. Either ground tissues, dermal tissues, and vascular tissues. So ground tissues are simple tissues, while vascular tissues and dermal tissues are complex tissues. So the ground tissue system is present in all plant organs. It has a variety of functions based on the cell type and location in plant. But in general, ground tissues serve many critical functions, including plant growth, structural support, food production, storage, and buoyancy. Examples are the hypodermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, and the pit. The dermal tissue system is the primary outer protective covering of the plant, since it is the layer that is in contact with the environment. It is a single layer of thick epidermal cells without chloroplast. So the function of the dermal tissue, aside from protection, is that it facilitates water and ion uptake in the roots and regulate gas exchange in the leaves and stem. So the types of dermal tissues includes the epidermal cells, stomata, lenticels, and trichomes. So in this figure, this is the trichome, this is your guard cells. The pore is the stomata. This is the trichomes, guard cells, and this is the stomata. Okay? The last tissue system is the vascular tissue. These are complex conducting tissues containing the vascular bundles, or the phloem and the xylem. So of course, the function is to conduct water and solutes and for mechanical support. And the types are the phloem and the xylem. So this is the phloem, this is the xylem. The phloem is involved in the transport of solutes. And the components of a phloem includes the sieve element, companion cells, sieve tube element, and the phloem parenchyma. The main conducting cells is the sieve elements. So what is a sieve element? A sieve elements are composed of several sieve tube. So this portion here is the sieve tube. And at the end of each sieve tube is a sieve plate. So this sieve plate connects one sieve tube to another, forming the sieve element. And this one is the sieve tube element. So the sieve elements retain their plasma membrane, but they have lost their nucleus and much of their cytoplasm. So they are dependent to their companion cells. These are the companion cells for their maintenance and other metabolic functions. The phloem parenchyma here, its function is to store food and other substances like resin and latex. And they are also important, or they also help in the transport of food or the solutes. The xylem. The xylem, of course, carries water and dissolved ions in the plants. The components includes vessel elements, tracheids, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fibers. The main conducting cell is the vessel element. It is long cylindrical tube-like structure that are dead cells at maturity, and it lacks plasma membrane. The tracheids, on the other hand, are long tube-like cells with lignified walls and tapering ends. The vessel element is highly or closely associated with the xylem parenchyma. So the xylem parenchyma is alive and they have thin walls. So they store food and actively transport selected solutes into and out of the vessel elements. The xylem fibers provides mechanical strength to the plant.